Hello, everybody. It's Dr. Zaino with 15 Minute Fuel. We're just in 15 minutes a day, we're in for your mind, your body, and your future. All right, so we just got back from Nashville, Tennessee. That's why it's 5:30 p.m. Central Time. And I committed to you guys for doing Fuel 365 days a week. So for the announcements, what do? Make sure you're on all our social media. That's going to be the SoundCloud, the Stitcher, the iTunes, the
Instagram, YouTube,
Facebook, Snapchat, Twitter. So just go to Dr. Zaino. Make sure you join and follow and do all the things that say there so you could be fully engaged with what we're doing in the I Am Hero project and you know all the cool things. So this weekend, I went to Dr. Josh Axe's event. Make sure you check him out. If you don't know who he is, check him out. He's growing. He's in when it comes to the whole nutritional field, you really love it, enjoy it. A lot of great tips there. We had a good time hanging out with him and all the other great docs that you've seen on here before, Dr. Rob Vasquez. I did a 15-minute fuel with Dr. Sean Stipich, who is actually Planet Stasiak in the WWE, WCW professional wrestling days. So it's really good to see him. Dr. Emmett was there. There's just so many people. If I'm forgetting you, I apologize, but it was not on purpose. So we just had a great time. Just to see, what was very amazing was to see someone who is a colleague of mine really grow to be, you know, one of the top in the world they do. So it's just, it's hanging around big-minded people. It's friending up, or like I like to say, hero up. You spend your time with a bunch of other heroes. So today what I'm gonna do, so I literally just walked in. We're going to talk about tips to travel, traveling tips that allow you to feel stress-free and have more energy when you travel. Because what happens, which is when it comes to traveling, when you travel, it's always the whole day, it drains you. A lot of times when people travel, they say, I was on the plane and someone coughed and I got sick. It's not that you're getting sick from the person sneezing. It's just that your immune system is down. Your energy is down. So let's go over tips to make traveling very, I'm not going to say fun because it's not always fun, but to be more stress-free, immune system building, and allow you to step off the plane like I did right now and have energy and be ready to rock and roll. All right, so these are the tips that we're going to do. The first thing you want to do is it all comes with preparation. You don't want to, a lot of times when you're in the airport, you want to be prepared at the airport knowing this. So I knew the plane took off at, let's say, 2:30. So if it's boarding at 2, I need to be there at the airport at 1. So that means, like MapQuest, it takes me a half hour to get there. We need to be out of there by 12:30. So no rushing. First thing, if you're going to the airport and you're rushing and you're shooting up your adrenaline, that's not good. It's total stressful. So that's going to start, remember, stress lowers immune system. Then prepare your meals. You bring your meals. Do not eat at the airport. Stop it. Don't even do it. So if you're somewhere, go to a Whole Foods. Prepare your own meals if you can. And try not to eat the airport food. But airport, there's some things you could get, I guess. They have little stations with organic nuts and seeds, and you can get the best you can. But you want to avoid that food as much as possible. Another big thing you want to do is make sure you keep your same routine. So, I mean, if you have a trip that's 5 in the morning, I get it. You can't really go up and do your routine. But if it's in the afternoon like this, I still woke up. I make sure I went to the gym. I try to keep my routine. See, that's what keeps you strong, your immune system steady, and your energy levels where they need to be. You stick to your routine as much as possible. So I went to the gym. I did some cardio at the gym. I drank, and when I do cardio, I'm able to drink a lot of water. So cardio could be you just go out for a walk, you know, and you just do something. Get the blood moving. Because when you're on the plane, I'll mention later, you know, I was squished in a really tight plane today. You know, the oxygen level's down, you get sleepy. So tons of water, I do more water leading up to the plane. Make sure if you are traveling, you do not drink alcohol the night before because it dries you and dehydrates you. We'll get into that. So you wanna make sure you're super hydrated for the plane. So start drinking plenty of water in the morning, more than you usually would. Then you get to the airport on time. Don't rush, because rushing just is no good. It doesn't put you in a good state. Then when you're at the airport, keep on drinking. Make sure you have your snacks with you. Don't let your blood sugar drop. Because when you get dehydrated and your blood sugar drops, then you feel like garbage. That's when you come off the plane and the whole day you feel like junk. It's because you're dehydrated and your blood sugar was down. So make sure those two things are there. So you could bring the snacks, you could bring the healthy foods with you on the plane and make sure you do that. Then on the plane, it's up to you. When you're on the plane, there's two things you could do. As some of you, that's a great time to get some work done, inspired work done. You know, if you're working on something or there was something on your to-do list you had to write out, or you're trying to think of your goals, that's a good time to think of your goals. I think we were this weekend, we were listening to that. I know when Dr. Josh, he flies, he always goes over his goals on a plane trip. That's like a routine he has. When he goes on the plane trip, he goes over his monthly goals and he tweaks them. So that could be kind of a routine for you if you are on planes a lot. And then for me, I want to get work done, but I just fall asleep. So that's just, when I'm running around, when I sit down in a tight plane like that, I'm out. So I sleep most of the time. And I prefer that because I get some rest and relaxation in there. But whatever it is, you know, do work, sleep, read, whatever it is, but just make it productive time. And I believe sleeping is productive, especially if you could catch up on a couple hours of sleep that you didn't get. Make sure you do that. Good, plane thing lands, and when the plane lands and you're back home, you know, make sure you get your baggage, of course. And remember where you parked, because I've seen and heard, and I've been in too many situations where I forgot where I parked because I thought I would easily remember it, and that causes more stress and havoc. And so these are just little things you can do. So what do we break it down to? Hydration is number one. Make sure you do some type of exercise in the morning to get the blood flowing before the plane. Make sure you drink plenty of water before, when you're at the airport waiting. I don't care how many times you got to pee. That's fine. Who cares? Drink. That hydration is going to keep you awake and aware. Not awake like alert, but it's going to keep you refreshed. You're not going to feel crappy. And make sure your blood sugar does not go down. Now when the plane lands, it just landed literally a couple, you know, 30 minutes ago, maybe 40 minutes ago. We got our baggage. We drove back home and it was great to see Justice and the family. And then we did our 15-minute fuel. Now back to the routine. So when you land, another thing that helps, because sometimes people retain water due to dehydration. Now what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to go work out. So that could be for someone, go for a walk. Get some exercise again in. I'm going to go work out, get some sweat going. Or if you have access to a sauna, do a sauna, get that sweat going again. And that'll make sure that you're strong, you're healthy. I don't get sick when I go to the airport. I'm well adjusted. I also got adjusted before I left for the trip. So everything's right there. So good, big things, hydration, food, keep your blood sugar stable. Make sure you exercise or do something, movement in the morning. Sleep or do work during the plane, make it productive. Sleeping's productive. When you come home, all right, you're back to your routine. Do some type of working out to get the blood going again, get the lymphatic system going, and it won't even faze you. So that is my tips on traveling. If you enjoy it, thumbs up, put a big heart on there. Please share this with friends and family. Thank you so much. I got another hero shirt on, if you can see the 100% hero. Everybody loved that. So we got 100% hero. If you have not gotten your shirts, they really do make you stronger and more powerful. I'm telling you, I've been wearing them and I have more energy than ever. So make sure you get your hero shirts, and that all the proceeds goes towards keeping We Are Heroes and our 15-minute fuels totally, you know, rocking for you guys as a gift from us. So please get your swag there. And any questions or comments, always private message me, because your comments and questions provide fuel. Hey, Doug's on here. He says, on the plane, number one. Oh, there you go. Good, good. Doug on there. Good. Doug, that was perfect. So Doug says, on the plane, number one, hydration. Work out in the morning. Get your monthly goals down. Don't eat the airport food. Very good. Get some sleep in. Sleep can be very productive when you get home. Work out. Perfect. Hey, Jen, good to see you. Feel like a superhero when I'm wearing mine. Absolutely. I'm telling you, these hero shirts mean a lot. All right. So have a great day. We had great feedback. So remember, when everybody compliments me on what's going on, they're complimenting you, because we're doing this together. So have an amazing Saturday. Tomorrow is Sunday. So, you know, Sunday is Sunday. All right. So you'll see Justice. He's going to talk about his, I definitely have some good stuff for him to talk about. He did a recital Friday. We'll talk more about it, but he's a performer. All right, so we'll talk about the tomorrow. Make sure it will be Sunday. We'll do it sometime during the day. Happy Mother's Day for the mothers out there. Thank you for all you do. That is your superpower. Did you know that? Like, you actually make people, which is like a crazy superpower. So thank you for doing that. That you make people and they make food. God, I can't make people or food. All right, well, we appreciate you for that. All right, God bless, guys. We'll see you soon. 15-minute fuel.